encouraging me to hear no. This is called pardon, madame. Pardon, madame. Running a little late as usual, I stop at the Bush's supermarket on Plymouth Road in Ann Arbor to pick up something for lunch. I'm on my way to meet a small group of friends, retired folks like me, who get together in the middle of the day to rather casually attempt to speak Italian. Nina, Nina is representing that. This is not Irene's class. This is something completely different. Irene and Irene is much more serious. I had years of French and Latin in high school, but neither involved much conversation. I lived with a family in Tuscany when I was 21 and learned to use Italian, however incorrectly, on an everyday level. But now that I'm retired and have time, I'm determined to improve it. This supermarket isn't a super fancy store. It's large and a cut above the Kroger, but hardly a gourmet market. I'm thinking of putting something together virtuous from the extensive salad bar, but I can't resist looking at the takeout hot buffet. There's a dish curiously labeled American goulash, which looks greasy and promising. Next to it, a tray of Cajun chicken, which various cut-up breasts, thighs, and drumsticks, apparently baked or roasted with some red spices and herbs, dusted on top. It looked rather dry. I am now considering the goulash, noodles and a beefy stew. A tall, good-looking, gray-haired gentleman, not young, comes over next to me. He's wearing sunglasses and well-cut jeans and an attractive pullover sweater in a small, tasteful geometric pattern. He catches my eye, gestures to the Cajun chicken. There's a little label, you know, on it. And he says, "Pardon, madame, c'est poulet." What? He wants to know if this is chicken. It takes a moment, but I answer smoothly, "Oui, monsieur, c'est poulet." Surprisingly, my accent sounds pretty good. "Oui, bien. Mais qu'est-ce que c'est, cajun?" He pronounces it cajun in French. Okay, he wants to know what Cajun means. I surprise myself with an answer right away. C'est à la mode de la Louisiane. He looks at me directly now, smiling. "Alors, madame, êtes-vous de la Louisiane?" Why would he think I was from Louisiana? I'm not from Louisiana, but my grandfather was. No, je suis d'ici, Michigan. Next, he says something I didn't catch and follows it with another question. I want to apologize for my bad French, but can't quickly formulate the sentence. All I can come up with is, "Je regrette." "De rien, madame, pardon." He puts two pieces of chicken in a container and says, "Alors, merci, madame," with a nod and a smile as he turns away. It was a pleasing surprise to speak French all of a sudden, out of context, without warning. I wanted to continue it. I call after him, "Au revoir, monsieur." I am so baffled by this puzzling, slightly surreal encounter in the midst of an American supermarket that I can hardly think straight. Why on earth had this man spoken to me in French? I've struggled to speak French when I've been in Paris, but this time the simple answer slid right off my tongue. Did this really happen? I fill half a soup container with the goulash, pick up a pound of coffee that we eat, and head for the checkout counter. But then I hesitate and I want to look around and see if I can spot this guy. I want to ask him why on earth he spoke to me in French. I try out a sentence in my mind. I don't get very far with it. He seemed to be alone. Surely any reasonably sophisticated Frenchman who has made his way to this slightly out-of-the-way supermarket on the edge of town should know the English word for chicken. Well, maybe he didn't know Cajun. But I don't see him anywhere. It's a large store with an odd layout. He's not at the checkout either. I'm in a hurry, a cashier is open, so I pay up and get in the car. When I arrive at the Jolly Italian group, they are discussing how to design a t-shirt for the group reading, "Mangiamo, ridiamo, studiamo un po'." I'm eager to tell them this story. They all agree this was certainly strange. They speculate. Joe says the purple streak in my hair makes me look European. He also says, maybe the guy was trying to pick me up. Unlikely, but thanks a lot, Joe. Reg points out that Cajun comes from Arcadian, the name of the French-speaking people who migrated down from Canada to Louisiana, so maybe that word just wasn't familiar to him. Maybe his English is poor and he's embarrassed to use it, says Nina. Maybe he's discovered that many people in Ann Arbor are well-educated and actually speak French. No other explanations are forthcoming. My old friend Judy Mitchell is a connoisseur of bizarre events and unexpected encounters. Now, you can read about her in the chapter called Witch Wedding. As soon as I get home, I call her in Maine, where she lives with her third husband. She ponders the stories for a few minutes and says, well, wait a minute. Wasn't your grandfather from Louisiana? Yes, Neville Henshaw was born in New Iberia. And this was a question about Cajun chicken. That can't just be a coincidence. Didn't he write stories about Cajuns? Well, yes, he did. Aileen of the Grand Woods, published in 1909, Tiger Bayou, 1931, and lots of short stories about the simple, honest folks out in the bayous. Judy says, okay, now I see it clearly. This was your grandfather come back to see you. I protest. This tall man didn't look anything like a fish. I never knew my grandfather. He died years before I was born. That doesn't matter, said Judy. He can come back in any form he likes. Maybe he always wanted to be tall. I'm sure he just wanted to take a look at you. I comment that I was slightly amazed at my smooth transition into French. Your grandfather spoke French, didn't he? Well, yes, he did. Maybe he was testing you. I bet he was pleased that you could speak some French. Or maybe he was channeling it to you. Judy sees no problem with this. See, she says, I know it. That was your granddaddy. He just wanted to check you out for a minute. There are lots of stories about time travel, connections to other times, other universes. I can send you a book about this. Two books, actually. No one has offered any other interpretation of this unusual encounter. Maybe it's better that I didn't find the man, letting his appearance remain a mystery. But I'm afraid I don't really think it was my grandfather, unless maybe it was.